गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, आई एम रोशाली धनोकर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर आई टी डिपार्टमेंट. इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो वी लर्न अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर एंड ऑल्सो एब्स्ट्रैक्ट डेटा टाइप्स विद एग्जाम्पल. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट एरेज एंड टाइप्स ऑफ एरे विच इंक्लूड्स सिंगल एंड मल्टी डायमेंशनल एरे. सो लेट्स सी कंसेप्ट ऑफ एरे. नेक्स्ट, in this video following points are covered, which includes what is arrays, real life examples of array, types of array, which includes single dimensional array, multi dimensional array with examples, advantages, disadvantages and also applications of arrays in data structure. And also there are some important questions which mostly asked in SPPU exam pattern. Next, what is meant by array? Array simply means similar types of collections of items, and these items are stored in contiguous memory location. The idea of array is to store multiple items of the same type together. This makes easy to calculate the position of each element by simply adding an offset, that is base value. Base value means memory location of the first element of that array. See in this diagram, this is the structure of array. First index is 0 and last index is 8. Array length is 9. Array always start with 0. Clear? So this index, which is called as array indices, and the elements are stored, which is called as array elements. So this is the structure of array. Array means collections of similar types of data. While programming, if you want to store integer types of data, then you need to store only integer types of data in the array. You don't store multiple, that is integer, character, string in one array, which is not possible. For that purpose, you have to use structure or union, etc. Clear? So array means collections of similar types of element. Next. Okay. So before start the types of array, these are some real life examples of arrays. So array means in row and column formats, in sequential or similar types of data. See here, this is the strip of tablets, then ice cube, egg cube, then this is a painting, color painting box, water bottle stand, then chase. These are the some real life examples of array. It stored collections of similar types of data. Clear? Next. So types of array. There are two types of array: single dimensional array, which is also called as one dimensional array, and another is multi dimensional array, that is two dimensional array. Single dimensional array always stored all the data in sequential format or one by one. Clear? And multi dimensional array stored all the data in rows and columns format, which is also called as tabular format or in matrix format. Okay, so this is the concept of single array and multidimensional array. Next, let's see what is meant by single dimensional array. So in this word dimensional, dimensional refers the array size, which is how big the array is. Single dimensional and multidimensional. So dimensional means array size. A single dimensional array declared as follow: data type, array name and size. This is the syntax of single dimensional array, where data type means type of element. For example, data type is integer, means which is stored all the elements which has integer type. Then array name. Array name may be, for example, student. And size means 10, means there are total 10 elements are stored. Clear? So this is the syntax of single dimensional array: data type, array name and size. Size is always represented by square bracket. Once the array is created, the size is fixed. It cannot be changed. Clear? If you want to add or insert 11th number location, but it is not possible because array size is fixed. So for that purpose, linked list, tree, graph, these types of data structure are used. because they are flexible and array is constant or fixed size. Clear? So this is the structure of single dimensional array. Next. Now this is again example of single dimensional array. For example, data type, array name and size, that is integer, num, 10. Num is a array name which is type integer and there are total 10 elements are stored. See in this figure 0 to 9. I already told you array always start with index 0. So there are total num of 0 to num of 9 elements are stored. Num of 0 references the first element of array and num of 9 references the last element of array. And this is the graphical representation of array, which is called as array index and which is called as array elements. Clear? So this is the structure of single dimensional array. Okay, next. Now the next type of array is multidimensional array, which includes two dimensional array. Dimensional means array size. This type of array represents and stores data in matrix format. The syntax of two-dimensional array is data type, variable name, row size and column size. In one-dimensional array, we have stored only the concept of elements. Clear? But here in two-dimensional array, we have to store row size and column size. So here, variable name represents name of the array. Row size indicates number of rows in the table and column size indicates number of columns in an array. So let's see example of two-dimensional array. Next. See here how to create two-dimensional array. For example, integer cells in square bracket 3 and again in square bracket 12. So this is data type, this is array name, 3 means rows and 12 means columns. Array always in the format of row and columns. Clear? So here row size is 3 and number of spans from 0 to 2. See here, there are total rows 3, 1, 2 and 3. Array always start with 0, means 0 to 2. And there are total columns 12. So 0 to 11. So total columns are 12, which is called as data index of rows and data index of columns. And this is called as data elements. Clear? So this is the concept of two-dimensional array, which indicates in tabular format or in matrix format. Okay, next. Next, advantages of array. Random access of element using array index by A of 2. So A of 2 using, we can access directly the elements which is stored in second position. This is the advantage of array. It uses less line of code. It creates a single array of multiple elements. Easy access to all the elements. It travels through the array becomes easy using a single loop. While doing programming, for traversing purpose, we use loop concept for the array. And sorting becomes easy. It can be accomplished by writing less line of code. So these are the advantages of array. Clear? Next. Now, again, there are some disadvantages of array. So main disadvantages of array is it allow a fixed number of elements or constant number of elements to be entered, which is decided at the time of declaration. So these advantages are overcome in the linked list or in trees or graph in this type of data structure. These all are flexible or dynamic. Array is a fixed and constant. And insertion and deletion of element can be costly, since the elements are needed to be managed in accordance with a new memory location. Clear? So these are the some disadvantages: fixed size and memory location problem. So these all disadvantages are overcome in linked list, tree, graph and other types of data structure. Clear? Next. Now, applications of arrays in data structure. So these are the applications. For example, array can be used for sorting the elements. Array can perform matrix operations. Array can be used for CPU scheduling algorithms, which concept is used in operating system. Array can be used in recursive function, etc. What is meant by recursive function, I will explain in my next video. Clear? So these are the applications of arrays in data structure, and that's why we use arrays while doing programming in data structure. Clear? Next. These are the some important questions which mostly asked in SPPU exam pattern. Then arrays, the types of array with example, the syntax, the advantages, disadvantages, etc. Next. So you understood each and every points or concept of array in detail. Thank you. Keep practicing.